In this lesson, we will change our application so that we can define a company for each contact. For this, we will need to create a relationship between these entities. And this means that we will need to go here into the data tab. And before we create a relationship, let me just first of all create here an entity diagram. This entity diagram gives you an overview of the entities you have in your application and the relationships between these entities. You can create multiple diagrams and select which entities you want to show. In our case, I'm going to add the company and the contact entity to the diagram. Okay, so now we need to create this relationship between this company and the contact entity. As we said, we want to be able to define for each contact the company the contact belongs to. This means that we will need to add a new attribute to the contact entity. So let's go ahead and do that. And we'll call this attribute company identifier. You'll notice that once I press enter here, you'll notice that the relationship is created. With each entity you create, a new data type is created to allow referring to a specific record of that entity. When you create an attribute with this data type, as you can see here, you are creating a relationship to the entity also known as a foreign key. So in this case, this attribute we created, it is because of this data type, company identifier, that we are creating a relationship between the company and the contact entities. Okay, before we continue to change our screens, let's just publish to send this information to the database. Okay, so let's go back to our screens, and what I want to do now, it's here on the contacts list, here on the contact screen, I want to show the company name for each contact. So to do that, in order to show here the company name, I will first need to fetch it along with the contact. So this means that here in the preparation, this aggregate, I will need to return also, along with the name of the contact and the phone number, I want to return also the name of the company and also the website. So let's add those attributes to the aggregate. The name and the website. And you will notice that for now they are empty, and they're empty because we haven't associated a company with any of these contacts. Once we do that, we will see this information here. Let's go back to the screen and let's add also these attributes to our table record. So the name of the company and the website. And let's change here this header because we already have a name here for the contact. Let's say that this is just the company. Okay, so we're done for the list screen. Now we need a way to indicate what is the company for each contact. In other words, we need to change the contact detail screen. We need to change this screen. Let me just close here this pane. We need to change it in order to edit the company that the contact belongs to. And we will do that by setting this attribute. So let's drag and drop this attribute here into the form right after the email. And since the company ID attribute is an identifier to the company entity, a combo box, this widget here, is added to the screen to edit this relationship. This combo box will list all the companies for the end user to select one and associate that company to that contact. Further ahead, we will see how to use this widget in more detail. For now, we'll just keep the defaults as it is, and we will publish and associate a couple of companies to our contact. Okay, so let's edit our contacts, and let's say that Joanna works for Microsoft, for instance, and let's save it. And there we have the information here in the contact list. Let's say that that Duane, for instance, works for Google, and Martha works for Google as well, for instance. And finally, let's say that Luis works for OutSystems. And there we have all the information about the company along with the contacts, and that's it.